From Hollywood, California, where even homeless people have gym memberships, it's the Josh McCuga Show. Tonight's guest, from Fox's Sleepy Hollow and FX's The League, Janina Gavankar. And now your host, a guy who was told in his last physical he's not Captain America, it's Josh McCuga.
All right, what's up, Josh McCuga Show fans? Back here for another episode. Before we get into it, you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Josh McCuga. Subscribe to the channel here. If you are out, like in a, let's just say it's like a big outdoor festival and you're meeting a bunch of people, be like, hey, my name is so-and-so. Have you ever watched the Josh McCuga Show? Help spread the word. It's that word of mouth thing that all the marketing people talk about. It's a pretty big deal. Tonight, my guest, we met on a show that no longer exists, but we stayed friends regardless. You've seen her on True Blood. You've seen her on Sleepy Hollow. You've seen her as my favorite person in the history of fantasy football, Shiva. Ladies and gentlemen, Janina Gavankar.
Hi. Last time I saw you, I had my hands
attacked
around
me.
Your neck.
Mm-hmm.
I was choking you.
Yeah. You don't know how many girls say that to me when
you said the wrong thing, my friend.
I did.
I don't remember what it was.
People tweet me that gif once to twice a week.
Really?
Yes. It's been made into
at you?
Yeah, like, hey.
I want that.
Yeah, I can tweet it right
Nobody
back at you.
Nobody tweets that at me.
Yeah. When I like mess up, it's you pulling me off. Yeah.
That show's not around anymore.
No.
But canceled. Yours is.
No. Well, this is here.
This is going.
The other show that I was on that network also was canceled.
No.
But yeah. What are you going to do? It's Hollywood.
It happens.
Hollywood, where all your dreams get smashed. so we became friends. Now, mm-hmm. Obviously I knew you from The League first and foremost.
Not obviously.
Because that was, one of my favorite shows of all time.
Yeah, it was a great show.
It was an amazing show. And you... Regardless of what other people say about the other characters on the show.
I thought you were going to say, regardless of what people say about you, you're kind of okay. You're okay.
People don't really like you that much is what I'm getting
at. I'm fine with it.
Yeah. you were a very integral part of that show because without you, there is no trophy.
Well, not in her opinion. Mm-mm. She's like, get me off your trophy.
Yes.
You're all idiots. You can do this without me. Please extract me from this situation that I'm involuntarily a part of.
But the question is, did you have somebody in your high school or growing up that, like, you had a big crush on that you would have made a trophy about?
Ooh, no.
See, we had
I one. Did, actually. He was my high school sweetheart.
Oh, was he?
And I made him mine, so it worked out.
Really?
Yeah, he's sweet. We're still friends.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
Did you have, like, a long, steady boyfriend through high school?
Yes, I was that girl.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Oh, no?
I shouldn't have said it like that.
Why did you say it like that?
No, I was, I didn't have a serious girlfriend until,
2 years ago.
20, yeah, basically, yeah. I was that dude in high school that I was like, let's hang out and party. And girls like, I don't know if we can date him. I was sort of like Stifler without like the drinking of the cum scene thing.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
That's sad for you.
No, it's not.
It worked out, so you're fine.
See, I'm fine. Yeah, it only took 30 plus years to get there. But we did it.
It was like such a try hard and I was very focused on what I was doing.
Oh, no.
So I didn't really have time for a lot of things.
Yeah.
So.
But now you have time to be on Sleepy Hollow.
Yeah.
Which is an awesome show. It's about Sleepy Hollow.
Yeah. Well, no, even though, weirdly, it had like a new... they rebooted the whole show, so now it takes place in D.C.
What?
I know.
And he's what? Is he a sleepy senator?
No, the same Ichabod Crane. You've really seen the show. Uh-huh. Thank you so much for watching.
Ichabod Crane. Had you told me you need to watch the show or I'm not coming on, I would have watched the show and thus been like, let's talk storylines. Spoil the finale.
Like this is why I choked you last time I saw you. It's all right. It's going really well for us both.
Just crushing. We are doing amazing. But here's the thing. You've been a part of... The Vampire Diaries,
yeah.
True Blood,
mm-hmm.
Sleepy Hollow.
Mm-hmm.
What's the deal with you and like...
Genre shows? I did another one called The Gates.
Yeah.
We had vampires and werewolves on that one. And then, didn't I just do something else recently?
Do you go into auditions and like draw blood and be like, cast me on this
show.
No,
I mean, this is not funny, but I really think the reason is because genre shows celebrate strong women, and they're unafraid of hiring us. Yeah. I really think that's it.
Really?
Yeah.
And when you go, see...
It's not like I'm like, I'm not doing it if it does, it's not fantastical. No, I'm not doing that. But also, every show on television right now is a superhero show, a fantasy show, or a cop show.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've done a lot of cop shows, too.
It's either you have a superpower, they solve it, or they're working on solving
it. But all of these shows, anything that's a procedural, there is a procedure to the way that you tell the story or solve the crime.
Dun-dun!
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, really. So any lawyer show, doctor show, cop show...
How are you not like
show?
That Chicago shared universe? Chicago Justice.
I'm
Chicago
from Chicago,
Med.
The Chicagoland area, too.
Yeah, I know.
I don't know.
It's bullshit, if you ask me.
It's okay.
Listen, Dick Wolf. I don't know if he produces those, but I figure he does.
He does. He does all of them.
Yeah.
Some of my friends are on those shows.
They should be.
Very good people.
All Chicago, all the time.
I know. It's kind of great, though, because, I mean, I left, but to see that... I left because there wasn't really... I didn't feel like I could, like, keep moving.
You had enough meat.
Yeah, or just I just wanted the big... ponds seem farther away, but I'm so excited that all of the actors that live in Chicago that are doing theater can actually
work and pay their rent.
I mean, come on, that's so nice to me.
Did you struggle in like that Chicago theater scene for a long time?
Yeah. Totally.
Yeah.
I'm like, please, anyone hire me. But I was also weirdly in a girl group signed to Cash Money Records at the time. I know, that's so weird. No, there's like giggles from the audience.
What was the girl group called?
Indira. I know.
What? Like know. Gandhi?
Like.
Indira?
Well, that's a, yeah, no. I mean, yeah, but no. I mean, same kind of name. We spelled it differently, but like, I mean, it's written in Sanskrit, so you could like spell it anything you want.
Sick.
We sounded like En Vogue, and we danced really hard. So like Sierra, you know, that recording artist, her choreographer was our choreographer. So we danced really hard, and we sang like En Vogue. That's
and then did you like tour?
We did like a very short tour.
Oh, man, can we find Indira on...
Probably, but there's not much.
Bring out Indira!
There they are, out of nowhere.
They come out and just start hardcore dancing?
I still know.
Were you the lead singer?
No. Oh, well, yeah, I mean, I was the, in my opinion...
If you were the Destiny's Child, who were you?
Third, I was, out of five girls, the third best singer and the second best dancer.
Okay. I feel like when a girl sees me at a bar, that's what she's like. He's like the third best looking one and like the second. Yeah, you know how it goes.
Yeah. I don't go to bars. I'm like an indoor kid.
Oh, no. I'm
not cool like that, man.
No, you're cool like that.
I'm like, hey, I want to hang out. Let's lay on our couches and stare at the ceiling and talk about aliens.
See, but you can do that if you go to bars. You just get real hammered and then you come home and lay on the couch because you can't move anywhere else.
Yeah. I'm like,
hey, did you always not drink?
In college, I had a lot of people that were like, I know how to make a drink where you can't taste the alcohol. Okay, I'll try it.
It's called roofies.
Yeah, right. Mm-hmm. And I would try to like take one sip and I'd be like, oh, this is, and then I would taste the alcohol and it'd be over.
Interesting.
Yeah.
See, I wish I had that kind of reflex because I would have saved myself upwards of $400,000 in alcohol. So now we're talking altfound.com. Tell me about this.
I started this thing. Okay. I launched it on January 1st.
Okay. Launch party I wasn't invited to.
Yeah,
awesome.
It was a launch party of one person.
Nice.
Me. I didn't tell anybody I was going to do it.
Sounds like a real good marketing idea.
I did a lot. I did a really big push.
Huge research.
I developed and designed this site that is made for people like me. Anybody who's watching knows that I am a geek. I have been very vocally one for many years.
Sure.
And there are a lot of brands that are geeky, but to me they feel childish.
Okay.
And I'm not.
So no Funko Pops for you.
I mean, I like that stuff, but like, the geeks have inherited the earth.
Mm-hmm.
The median age of gamers is 35 years old. Mm-hmm. We're all grown and sexy, and that's it. Like, I don't really feel like there is something that really speaks to us the way that
sexy geek chic.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you know, I started this thing, and right now it exists as a site. There are podcasts and unscripted shows that I'm shopping around right now that will then become part of this brand. So as it grows organically, it will become a sort of media lifestyle.
So
brand.
When other things happen, you're going to tell people.
So yeah, I'll tell them. Hmm.
Alt found? Will there be an alt found party at Comic-Con this year that we can?
I don't know. I mean, I'm not really. I'm not a person that's like, go to my thing. I'm like, if it's for you, then you will feel it in your loins.
Yeah.
You know?
Definitely.
You'll be like, oh yes.
Feel it in the loins.
That is for me.
You do you want to feel some other stuff in your loins?
Yeah, sure. Depends
like
on what it is.
The game, The First and the Curious.
Oh! Whoa!
This is a playoff, obviously, Fast and Furious, and Fast 8 is
not
coming
obviously.
Out.
I thank First you and for the clarifying. Curious?
First and the Curious? The Fast and the Furious?
Yeah, okay.
See, there you went.
Yeah.
The Fate of the Furious, F8. There's 8 of these
Looks
movies
great.
Now.
Looks great.
This time they're racing submarines.
But it's all about family.
It's all about
you
family.
Wouldn't, you wouldn't.
It's always been about family.
You wouldn't leave family,
Dom.
Would you? It's like in his contract that he has to say the word family.
10 to 20 times a movie. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then every Facebook post is
about the
family.
Or at least the number, so this time he says it 8 times. The last one he said it 7 times.
Yeah, that's, that makes sense. That's good marketing, branding. You should use that on altfound.com.
It's an Easter egg.
Here we go.
Okay, go ahead.
All right, so these are the first bigs in your life, and you could tell us some stories about them.
Okay. Bigs?
Like, you know, first time you experienced
things. Oh, like
things.
Shit that went down.
Yeah.
It was a big deal.
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
Your first crush.
Was my high school sweetheart.
Oh.
I fell in love.
Jake Serpentine.
Adam. And that's a good name. His name was Adam Zagrossi.
Adam Zagrossi, good Italian kid from Joliet, Illinois.
Yeah.
Woo. You know and who else is from Joliet?
Who?
Rudy. Rudy Rudiger.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember where he was standing in Ooh. The room that he was in.
What grade was this?
This
Ninth
was
grade?
My, I was 13 years old.
Ooh.
This was the summer before high school. I was like taking a, you know, American politics, not politics
in
class.
In the summer?
Citizen American
summer school?
Is that what you citizen?
No, civil.
You know what I'm talking
yeah,
about?
Yeah, yeah.
One of those
American
things.
Civics.
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 Teacher, is that
Come
a
on.
Thing?
Civics.
Yeah.
Yep. We got a teacher in the crowd. Makes us legit.
Yeah, we're gonna reference a lot of things. We're gonna check it, fact check it with the teacher in the crowd
yep.
tonight.
American Civics.
Yes.
You see Jake Serpentine.
No.
Adam Zagrossi.
Yeah. Oh, he had these like long lashes. And I just thought he was so cute. Oh my God. I remember how it felt.
Did you pass him a note that was like, sup?
No, because I had a very strict upbringing.
Oh.
I was not allowed to date until I was 16.
Whoa.
And I was like,
I don't think I wanted
so
a date until I was
cute.
16 because I was like, had my parents take me somewhere?
I didn't either. I was just like, I liked being able to tell people that I was like, I'm not allowed to date until I'm 16. I was
but
such
I'm
a, oh God. And I think about myself when I was a kid and I roll my eyes the way everyone else rolled their eyes at me. And now I understand why.
Were you an only child?
No, I had an older sister.
Oh, man.
She's still alive.
She
it's fine,
died.
Everyone. She's alive.
Did she know Adam Zagrossi?
No. The time though.
Oh man.
But we became friends.
So what was like the courtship like?
There was no courtship. Generally, there is never a courtship with me and boys. I'm just like, I choose you.
Yeah, I guess that when you look like that, that kind
of
works.
That's
I'm like,
nice of you.
Hey, would you like to be locked in this locker in high school? Cool, you're gonna like me or I'm not gonna let you out.
Yeah. I certainly wasn't cool. He was really he's still sweet. He's
What's he do now?
Good guy. He works in corporate sales in Joliet. No, in a different Diamond, Illinois.
Diamond, Illinois. It's a girl's best friend. Yep. All right.
Unless it's a blood.
first kiss was I'm guessing with
Him.
Adam Zagrossi.
Same dude.
Where well, like did was it like under mistletoe?
It was in the back of the car as he was dripping. We were being driven home.
By who? Your parents?
By his parents in a minivan.
Zagrossi with some balls
I'm
on him.
Saying.
Kissing you in front of his parents.
And not well, unless Woo. They were looking in the rear view. And they drove me home, and it was New Year's.
Holy cow.
And, yeah.
New Year's kiss with Adam Zagrossi. First concert.
First concert. I think my parents took me to Michael Jackson.
Nice.
Yeah, dude.
That's big time. Yeah. Which tour was that? Was that like the Remember the Time tour?
I was too little. Like, I don't know. I was like 3 or something.
3?
I did take my...
Your parents are strict upbringing. They're like, we're taking you to MJ.
You know what? I wouldn't remember it if I was 3. So maybe I was 6.
Okay.
I remember being scared by something, though.
Maybe it was the Thriller? Maybe.
Maybe.
Could have been. He comes out as a werewolf.
On the tour he did?
I don't know. You were at the concert.
I don't remember.
Okay.
I'll have to ask my mother.
First car.
I still have this same
The one that
car.
You pulled up yeah. in the other night? Get yes. the hell out of here. What is that, a Toyota 4Runner?
Why would you tell everybody
oh,
that?
Oh, sorry. I couldn't tell. It looked like a Toyota. My bad. Let's cut. We'll bring that back.
No, it's fine.
So is it an, what kind of car was it?
No, it's fine. I don't care. No one's going to notice it. It's the car that my dad got me for graduating college.
My dad was legit pissed when I graduated college.
What do you mean?
He's like, your grades are freaking terrible. You're never going to get a job. And I was like, I'm going to do comedy. And he was like,
oh
fuck.
Oh, jeez. What are you studying?
International business logistics.
How's that working out for
Great.
You?
Great. Crushing it. Just ringing up numbers back here. Hold on. Stocks, bonds. Yep. Yeah. Uh-huh. Cool. Sorry. We got 10 minutes left. I got to short some currency.
Okay. Great.
And watch a lot of billions on Showtime. Where'd you go to college?
University of Illinois at Chicago.
Whoa.
Yeah. So he got me that car, and I still drive it. It has less than 100,000 miles on it. I've been here 10 years because I keep getting shipped out to do shows elsewhere.
Oh, so it just sits
like,
around.
Why would I? Yeah, and I'm like, why would I buy a car?
Yeah.
My daddy got me this nice car. He was nice enough to support me.
Yeah, I think my dad sold my car to pay for my college education, which he was still pissed that he paid for. All right, first time on an airplane. Do you remember that?
No, okay. I was very lucky. My parents dragged my sister and I around the world. So.
Oh.
Actually, it's a cool. Okay, so my mom and my dad both got pilot's license. My parents. Jeez.
Yeah.
Jeez.
My parents barely got a driver's license. When I was going for my driver's license, my dad's driver's license was expired, so we had to get it, and then I had to wait like 2 more weeks to get my driver's license because my dad forgot.
You're Greek, right?
No, Italian.
Wait, what's your last name? Just kidding.
That.
Okay, so, just kidding. My dad was like such a forward-thinking guy.
Yeah.
He came to this country with $9 and a scholarship from India, like Whoa. Many people that were in his, like if you have a bunch of Indian friends, ask them about their parents and if they are or were doctors or engineers, they mostly came in with the same student visa, which allowed you $9, what, and a scholarship.
From the Indian government, was like, here's $9.
No, from the American, like, I don't actually $9? Understand what the $9 is about. I need to figure that out, because a lot of people have this weird story.
So weird.
And he went to the Milwaukee School of Engineering.
Look at that.
From Bombay to the Milwaukee School of Engineering.
Crushed it. Milwaukee and Bombay. Sister cities. You didn't know that.
Yeah.
They look a lot alike. Same weather.
Yeah.
Same kind of traffic patterns.
It sounds terrible.
All right, let's finish. Okay, last sorry. One. First porn you ever saw.
First porn I ever saw. Probably something in high school.
Yeah.
That somebody was like, you've got to watch this.
Yeah, like a creepy VHS that was being passed around by friends.
More like on the internet, but
yes, it is.
Is that what yours
was? Yeah, it was like.
What was yours?
It was called Loose Ends 2.
You remember it? I love that.
Yeah, like, you know, like all your buddies, like, oh, we got this one from like the older kids in high school, and then, you know.
But the thing is that I remember seeing it and being so freaked out because I hadn't even lost my virginity yet.
Yeah.
So I was like terrified.
I had no idea what was going on.
I was like, my parents are going to find out because they can read my mind and I am grounded.
I think I like went to church. I was raised so Catholic. I went to church and I started like crying. And I was like, what happened? I was like, nothing. I'm just being a little emotional. I was like, I'm sinning.
No, come on.
And then like a year later, I was like, this is awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. But here I am. Living the dream with my international business degree. We'll be right back with more Josh McCook Show after a word from our sponsor. Hey there. The Surgeon General recommends that when you leave the house, you bring your keys, your wallet, and of course, your Magic Hat beer. It's for drinking and curing most diseases, along with public anxiety and when girls don't like you. Magic Hat beer. It's perfect. Should I drink it? Should I drink it now? All right, and we're back here on the Josh McCuga Show. Clap it out. We're here with Janina Gavankar. You guys know her from Sleepy Hollow, The League. The Vampire Diaries, True Blood, Gates, Chicago area performances,
yeah.
All of that
Yar.
In general. Yar, Endira, the girl group, sponsored by Cash Money Records. Oh, Cash Money!
Yeah.
Please tell me that you might do a Cash Money party and they...
So many. I sang on one of Lil Wayne's tracks back in the day. I did it, dude. It's how I learned how to produce.
Wait a second.
I know, it's weird. It's really weird.
Can we find this Lil Wayne song?
That was before he was
Weezy. I did it. I wish I would have known this. We just would have listened to Indira songs the whole time.
No, we wouldn't have.
Well, how
you
was
can do that behind my back.
We're supposed to. Oh, I'm going to find them. What was your transition from like theater in Chicago and out here? And what's the biggest difference for you here rather there?
In Chicago?
Yeah, or like.
Oh, gosh. Hopefully I'm a better actor now.
Was there ever
a bit more experience.
Was there a role for you that was like the one that took you to the next level?
Yes. My first series was The L Word.
Yeah.
I played this amazing character that I loved and I'm so happy to.
So when you go to West Hollywood, you are like a god.
Nobody recognizes me because she was like cornrowed and thugged out and hardcore. And yeah, people don't really go. Well, that's, yeah, nobody, no. Which is great. That's exactly what I want.
Would you ever want to go into like the Abbey with cornrows just to see what happens? Because I would like to be there.
I wonder if they would, if they care anymore.
But the L Word was like a big deal.
It was a huge deal. Mm-hmm. It was such a big deal, but you know, it was a really long time ago, and thankfully there are more gay characters on television, so it can fade into the background. There was so much pressure at the time for us to like be the people that spoke on behalf of lesbians everywhere. It's like, right. It's just one show and it's fiction, so it's fine. It's not a documentary. We're not like doing really, you know, really intense. No, we still did intense stories, but. You know, it's not the end all be all.
Right.
But it was the only thing that was available.
Was that, was, have any of your roles, you said you had like a strict upbringing, has any of your roles like kind of freaked your parents out?
Of course.
Yeah.
All of them. Of course. But I mean, but the thing is that, you know, my parents also understood that they raised a risk taker who was like, you know, I'm going to do whatever it takes to be the best artist that I can be in this lifetime. And that means taking a lot of risks.
Sure.
You know?
I mean, there's a lot of people that have the, like, advantage to, like, I'm not going to say no, but that don't take the risks. And, like, I don't need to take the risks. And there's the people that do.
I don't really know anybody like that, though.
I know.
I don't know any successful artists that have that MO.
That didn't take it.
No, you have to be willing to jump off a cliff at any point.
Right.
For what you believe is the right thing in the moment.
See? That's awesome. When you, because I know that in True Blood you were naked a couple times. What was like
a couple times? We were constantly naked all the time. I was scared out of my mind. We were all on fear diets, and we still talk about it.
Fear diets being
like, oh my god! When I joined the show, it was the biggest show on the planet. It was what Game of Thrones is now.
Yeah.
Of course, Game of Thrones dwarfed us tenfold.
Yeah.
But
with
at the
nudity
time,
as well.
Yeah. Well. I don't know. Everybody's over nudity at this point.
Well,
aren't they? I don't know.
I still love it on Game of Thrones. Wait, what? No.
But it was a big deal, you know. And I just had this like, oh my god, I'm on the biggest show, and I'm gonna just be fully exposed all the time.
Yeah. And what we're like.
But the thing that's interesting about that is it makes you double down on what you're putting forth.
Okay.
So if you are like, I have the courage to be buck-ass naked, then that means I also have to have the courage to do things emotionally within these scenes that are on par with how raw we all are.
Right.
Right?
Right.
And I think that's what made it really Lightning in a Bottle. It was a really special show.
Yeah, for sure.
You know?
Is there, have you stayed in contact with a lot of those people?
Yeah.
Like, is that what you get noticed from the most?
I don't really get noticed.
What?
People don't believe me when I say this, but I don't really. I mean, I'm like, I'm wearing makeup right now. I have like fake eyelashes on. I'm wearing a dress. You think I look like this every day? No.
No.
I'm not trying to look like this every day.
I look like this all
the
time.
I'm in drag right now.
Mostly,
you know what I mean?
In purple. Yeah.
This is a great color on you.
Oh,
by the way.
Thank you. A lot of lavenders in my collection.
It's
mostly
very
pastels.
Good. It's good.
Thank you. Thank you.
So basically, I don't really have to. It's also, you get what you seek out, right?
Sure.
So I'm not trying to have that attention, so I don't really get it.
Okay. And that's.
Which is not helpful when trying to advance one's career.
Like altfound.com.
In the long run.
which I launched and nobody knows about.
Yeah.
Check it out.
But it's funny. A lot of people do know about it. And and it's in its own way gaining a lot of traction. And as I'm shopping different shows around town, people are like, we really like what you're doing with this thing.
Thank you for noticing. Yeah.
But I'm not going to inauthentically try to garner a lot of attention for something that I have a long game plan with. I'd much rather people grow with the site and grow with the idea, and then we can all build it together.
That's how I felt about Chipotle at the beginning. I was like, I don't want a lot of people to know about this because I felt like it was like my neighborhood spot.
Yeah.
And now everybody's like, I love Chipotle from the beginning. I was like, but did you? Because I was there. I was on the ground.
From
I was pounding
one.
Pavement.
Yeah.
Same with Journey. But that was a little whatever. So you came out here. Is there obviously after Adam Zagrossi, there was like some time in between. I know you're with somebody now. We don't talk about it. But what was dating like for you in L.A.?
I met my ex-boyfriend like right off the bat. And I was like, I choose you.
Oh, no.
Yeah. And then 5 years went by.
Holy cow.
I know.
I do that.
Yeah. I do that thing where I'm like,
choose.
I choose, but I'm right.
You're right.
I'm right. Because 5 years is an incredible amount of time.
See, I'm like that game. You know, you ever been to a carnival where there's all those balloons and you have to throw darts and pop them?
Yeah.
I miss all of the balloons.
Yeah, but you made it once.
I made it once.
Yeah. It's working out for you.
My arm is sore, but I made it. I did it. Is there any dating stories that you have out here or like guys approaching you? Approaching you anywhere? That are, is
no,
like
I have
awkward.
Resting bitch face, so people don't really...
Do you, though? See, a lot of girls... Let's move on into the deep end.
Yeah.
Let's move on to the deep end. This is part of the show where we talk like some just... We're going to spin the wheel of destiny. If you don't want to answer the question, you don't have to answer it.
Ooh.
But I would prefer that you did. And if you don't, Magic Cat will cancel the show.
Great.
And that's that.
Paint. Best / worst date you've ever been on, but this is a date thing next. I can tell you the best, actually. I can tell you the best. This is not a date.
Okay.
But it's kind of a date.
Okay.
It's a thing that really, like, so my ex-boyfriend, the moment that really, like, solidified our relationship.
Yeah.
So this is messed up, though. So I was hanging out with an old friend of mine. He cracked his head open on the floor of a restaurant, and we had to go to the ER. It was a terrible, terrible night. And my ex-boyfriend, he has a name. His name's Angelo.
You like the Italians, don't you?
Greek.
Ah, Greeks.
And so he was like, where are you? Do you want to get lunch at... And I was
the
so
hospital
new
cafeteria.
To, no. Oh. I was at Jerry's Deli by Cedar Sinai.
Yeah.
And I was so new to L.A. I didn't know what that was or anything. And so we sat in a booth.
Down.
No.
Jerry Deli's gone, yeah.
Oh, that's sad.
I know.
So we sat in a booth across from each other. Boys, you should use this. Okay. Ooh. So we sat in a booth, and I was sort of like exhausted and very stressed out, and I'd never
covered
really
in
been
blood
through.
From a
I was very worried for my friend, and he could see my level of anxiety, and he said, do you want me to go sit over there with you?
Oh.
And I said, yeah. And then he just sat next to me, and that was it. It was just like, this guy has my back.
Interesting.
Isn't that sweet?
Yeah. That is sweet.
Steal that one, bud.
Sit next to your lady. Gentlemen.
Well, we weren't even like really, you know, I really liked him, but we weren't really in a relationship and that was it.
Yeah. See, all it takes is sitting next to you. That's never worked for me. I'm like, do you want to sit over there? She's like, you should stay on your seat. Yeah, that's probably a good call.
Okay, next.
All right, do you want to do one more?
Sure.
All
that's it? There was only one round?
Yeah.
All right.
Do you want to do one more?
No, we'll do anything.
Spin one more, Paul.
Okay.
Here you go. It's the Wheel of Destiny. I sang. I think I had too many magic hats in 20 seconds. The hardest you've ever cried. Because I can tell you the hardest I've ever cried. I just watched that movie,
Lion.
Mine's
terrible. My dad died.
It was the worst
ever.
I'm sorry. That's terrible.
Okay. Listen, everybody's going to
it. Wasn't in a plane crash,
it.
Was it?
No.
Oh, okay, good.
What, did you watch Iron Fist?
Yeah, that show was my retail.
I cried at that too. Because it was terrible. And Marvel's never going to hire me now.
They weren't going to hire me to begin with. You have too much chest hair. You can't be on the shows. Yeah, good call.
Yeah, that was really it.
Yeah.
That was it.
I'm sorry. I didn't know.
It's
That's
okay.
terrible.
You know what helped me was that.
Drugs.
Was when a friend of mine. Yeah. And a friend of mine. Sent me a book, and the first chapter said, this is a universal experience.
Yeah.
If you're lucky, you know, it should never be the other way around.
Sure.
And the best case scenario is that your parent will go before you, and we will all feel it.
Mm.
And the older you get, there's a collective grief that you share with your peers, and that's it.
Yeah, right?
And that was like, oh, God, yes, that's true. If you can zoom out, then you can understand that it's a universal experience.
Very well said. You have good friends.
Is this supposed to be a comedy show?
Listen, it's a everything show.
Yeah, sure.
Tears, laughter,
right.
Making fun of me, all that. Let's go into three for the road, 3 minutes, rapid fire questions.
Oh.
Are you ready? In 3, 2, 1, go. Do you take vitamins every day?
No.
Tap water or bottled water?
Tap.
You ever fail a class in high school or college?
No.
Xbox or PlayStation?
Platform agnostic, excuse me.
Oh, whoa. Christmas or Thanksgiving?
Thanksgiving.
Elton John or Billy Joel?
I went to see both of them together in concert when I was living in Chicago.
I saw them in college together. It was pretty amazing.
Oh, yeah. Okay, keep going.
You ever had a teenage rebel phase?
No, I was too much of a square.
Oh, man. Sexier accent, Aussie or British?
Aussie.
Yeah, fucking spiders, mate. Cheetos or Doritos?
Cheetos.
You could have a drink with any dead person. Who would it be?
My dad!
I laid you up. I was like, if she doesn't say your dad after that one,
I don't know
what she's going to say. NSYNC or Backstreet Boys?
NSYNC.
Wrong. Indira.
Dirt.
How often do you wash your hair?
Every 2 days, 3 days.
Okay. Can you drive stick?
Nope.
Do you like country music?
Sure.
Michael Jackson or Prince?
Oh, Prince.
Even after your first concert experience.
Yeah.
Dunkin' Donuts or Krispy Kreme?
Dunkin's.
McDonald's or Wendy's?
McDonald's.
Do you sleep on your back or side of your stomach?
On my left side, like this.
Ooh, okay. Solid. Flip cup or beer pong? Yeah, you don't drink. Barbecue ribs or buffalo wings?
Barbecue.
Are you worried about climate change?
Yes.
Sopranos or Breaking Bad?
It hurts. Breaking Bad.
If you had a hot stalker, would you be okay with that?
Are they really smart?
Yeah, sure. I mean, they're stalking you, so they have to be creative. Minute 25.
Maybe.
What Friends character are you?
None of those entitled white people.
Oh, burn. You ever been blacked out?
No. They're real funny, but no.
Favorite SNL cast member?
Oh, current?
Yeah, sure.
Kate
or ever. Yeah, she's great. Happy Gilmore or Billy Madison?
Which one's Stop Looking at Me, Twan?
That's Billy Madison.
That one.
Boom. Jennifer Lopez or Jennifer Garner? 1 minute.
Garner?
Star Trek or Star Wars?
Star Wars.
Favorite Girl Scout cookie?
Minty chocolate. Come on.
Thin mint?
Yes.
Minty chocolate?
The correct one.
Pretty sure that's not a brand, but there we go. Sean Connery or Roger Moore?
Oh, Sean Connery.
Best fast food french fries?
That's not fast food, but Umami has really good sweet potato fries.
See?
It's like...
You're killing me, Indira. How often do you call your parents or mom?
Often.
If you had a band, what would you call it besides Indira?
Chekhov and his gun.
Chekhov and his gun?
That's
like
a theater.
Some theater reference.
Yeah.
Can a guy with chest hair wear a deep V, 15 seconds?
Sure. Does he wax?
No. He has terribly bad chest hair.
He goes hard.
Yep. Do you collect anything? Five.
Yeah.
Dogs or cats?
Dogs.
If you had a TV show, what would you call it?
Chekhov and his gun.
No! No more Chekhov! Damn it. All right. Finally, last one. Are DJs just dudes who are good at iTunes?
That's a very long conversation.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, that'll be for the next time that the lovely Janina Gavankar is on the Josh McCougar Show.
Thank you. For
that was
me.
So much fun. You're great. This was fun.
It got deep.
Drank 3 beers while I interviewed you. Thanks for watching this episode of the Josh McCougar Show. We release episodes every other Wednesday, so subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Go to Facebook, I'm also there. Support our Patreon campaign. If you're watching the Josh McCougar Show, you're doing something right. And that something right is giving random people hugs when they don't want them.